Hello students, hope you all are doing well. Welcome to the new class of utilization of electric power. Today we are going to study a special kind of topic that covers under electric heating and welding process in your syllabus, and this is electrodeposition. So let us know what is electrodeposition, how electrodeposition can be done, and what are the application of electrodeposition. So the contents that we are going to deal in this video, these are introduction, process of electrodeposition, electrodeposition clearing, depositioning of alloys, electro polishing or electro buffering, and the references from where I have collected this information. So first, we need to know what is electrodeposition. Electroplating is a process that uses electric current to reduce dissolved metal cautions so that they form a coherent metal coating on an electrode. Right. Now the process used in electroplating is called electrodeposition. Electroplating, we all know about electroplating. Most of us, we have studied in our chemistry syllabus that what electroplating is, and the process that used in electroplating is called electrodeposition. So this is a chemical process. It is analogous to a galvanic sail acting in reverse. The part to be plated is the cathode of the circuit. In one technique, the anode is made of the metal to be plated on the part. Both components are immersed in a solution called an electrolyte containing one or more dissolved metal salts as well as other ions that permit the flow of electricity. A power supply supplies a direct current to the anode, oxidizing the metal atoms that it comprises and allowing them to dissolve in the solution. So this is a reverse galvanic cell process where anode, direct current is being provided. Let me show you a figure. And yes, see, this is a process of electroplating, and here electrodeposition is being done. Here from power supply, cathode is being taken and anode is used by a metal rod. At the cathode, the dissolved metal ions in the electrolyte solution are reduced at the interface between the solution and the cathode, such that they plate out onto the cathode. The rate at which the anode is dissolved is equal to the rate at which the cathode is plated. That all we know, because in the both the cases the rate will be same. That is the current through the circuit. In this manner, the ions in the electrolyte bath are continuously replenished by the anode. Other electroplating process may use a non-consumable anode such as lead or carbon. In this technique, ions of the metal to be plated must be periodically replenished in the bath as they are drawn out of the solution. The most common form of electroplating is used for creating coins such as pennies, which are small zinc plates covered in a layer of copper. Now, process of electrodeposition. How this electrodeposition can be done? The cautions associated with the anions in the solution. These cations are reduced at the cathode to deposit in the metallic zero valence state. What are the examples where this type of electrodeposition is being shown? In an acid solution where copper is oxidized at the anode to Cu2 plus by losing 2 electrons. The Cu2 plus associates with the anion SO2 minus in the solution to form copper sulfate. At the cathode, the CO2 plus is reduced to metallic copper by gaining 2 electrons. See this example, this process should be very easier for you because we have all gone through the chemistry subject, right? Yeah, this type of expression, this type of chemical reaction, we are all known to this. So this is an example of electrodeposition. The result is the effective transfer of copper from the anode source to a plate covering the cathode. The plating is most commonly a single metallic element, not an alloy. However, some alloys can be electrodeposited, notably brush and solder. So this is an example as well as the description of process of electrodeposition. Many plating baths include cyanides of other metals like potassium cyanide in addition to cyanides of the metal to be deposited. See in this figure you can see there is sulfate in the solution SO42-, and the metal plate is of copper. This free cyanide facilitated anode corrosion, helped to maintain a constant metal ion level and contribute to conductivity. Since from anode, the metal is getting connected with the cathode ion. So to maintain the same level of anode metal, these cyanides are used. Additionally, non-metal chemicals such as carbonate and phosphate may be added to increase conductivity. When plating is not desired on certain areas of the substrate, stopcocks are applied to prevent the bath from coming in contact with the substrate. Typical stopcocks include tape, foil, lacquers, and waxes. Now, very important, what are the application of electrodeposition? Where electrodeposition is being used in today's industry point of view? Since its invention in 1805 by Italian chemist Luigi, electroplating has become an extensively used industry coating technology. Its application are mainly in the following three groups. It will be actually three. The last part has been updated. So first is decoration. Putting a more expensive metal onto a base metal surface in order to improve the appearance. Applications are jewelry, furniture fittings, builders hardware, and tableware. Protection, corrosion resistant coatings such as chromium plating of automobile parts and domestic appliances, zinc and cadmium plating of nuts, screws and electrical components. Wear-resistant coatings such as nickel or chromium plating of bearing surfaces and own shafts and journals. Electroforming. Manufacture of sieves, screens, dry shaver heads, record stampers, molds, and dies. So these all are the application of electrodeposition. Now electrodeposition clearing. How we can clean the metals, how we can clean anode cathode after the process. This is a very important part because some chemical reaction is happened over there and we need to clean all the ions. So cleanliness is essential to successful electroplating since molecular layers of oil can prevent adhesion of the coating. ASTM B322 is a standard guide for cleaning metals prior to electroplating. This can be available in internet. Cleaning process includes solvent cleaning, hot alkaline detergent cleaning, electro cleaning, and acid treatment, etc. The most common industrial test for cleanliness is the water break test, in which the surface is thoroughly rinsed and held vertical. Hydrophobic contaminants such as oils cause the water to bead and break up, allowing the water to drain rapidly. Perfectly clean metal surfaces are hydrophilic and will retain an unbroken sheet of water that does not bead up or drain off. ASTM F22 describes a version of this test. You can go through this particular test in YouTube also. You can get a wonderful video. This test does not detect hydrophilic contaminants, but the electroplating process can displace these easily. The solutions are water-based. Surfactants such as soap reduce the sensitivity of the test and must be thoroughly rinsed off. So these are the process by which electrodeposition cleaning can be done. Deposition of alloys. It is possible to deposit alloys also provided the electrode potential of the constituent metals are not much different. Electroplating of brass and bronze are the best example. For this, the anode is made up of an alloy to be deposited, and the electrolyte consists of a mixture of electrolytes and which could have been employed for separate deposition of metal conjugation. For brass plating, solution of double cyanides of zinc and potassium and copper and potassium is used as electrolyte, and current density of 25 to 40 ampere per square meter is used. In the below figure, you can see the example, the process after electroplating. These metals, the brass and the bronze metal, these have been electroplated. Electropolishing or electrobuffering. It is also known as electrochemical polishing or electrolytic polishing, especially in the metallography field. It is an electrochemical process that removes material from a metallic workpiece. It is used to polish, passivate and deburr metal parts. This process basically makes the surface smoother. It may be used in lieu of abrasive fine polishing in microstructural preparation. So it is again a very fine process. For microstructural preparation, we use electropolishing or electrobuffering. Now, water electropolishing. Let us get a descriptive depth knowledge on electropolishing. Typically, the workpiece is immersed in a temperature controlled bath of electrolyte and serves as the anode. It is connected to the positive terminal of a DC power supply, the negative terminal being attached to the cathode. A current passes from the anode where metal on the surface is oxidized and dissolved in the electrolyte to the cathode. At the cathode, a reduction reaction occurs which normally produces hydrogen. Electrolytes used for electropolishing are most often concentrated acid solutions having a high viscosity, such as mixtures of sulfuric acid and phosphoric acid. Other electropolishing electrolytes reported in the literature include mixture of perchlorates with acetic anhydride and methanolic solutions of sulfuric acid. To achieve electropolishing of a rough surface, the protruding parts of the surface profile must dissolve faster than the resistance. This process, referred to as anodic leveling, is achieved by a mass transport limited dissolution reaction. Anodic dissolution under electropolishing conditions deburs metal objects due to increased current density on corners and bars. Most importantly, successful electropolishing should operate under diffusion limited constant current plateau, achieved by following current dependence on voltage under constant temperature and stirring condition. This can be studied by polarization curve. So application of electro polishing. It has several application in metal finishing industry because of its simplicity and can be applied to objects of complex shape. Typical examples are electro polished stainless steel drums of washing machines and stainless steel surgical devices. It is also commonly applied to the preparation of thin metal samples of for transmission electron microscopy because electro polishing does not cause mechanical deformation of surface layers usually observed when mechanical polishing is used. Ultra high vacuum components are typically electro polished in order to have a smoother surface for improved vacuum pressure, outgassing rates, and pumping seat. So these are the references, some website, some paper from which you can go through this topic. You can have detailed explanation of this topic from the video mentioned over here. So I will suggest definitely go through this video. And if you feel any doubt, any question, any queries about this, please let me know. I'll definitely solve that. So thank you, students. Thank you for watching this video, and have a good day. Thank you.